One, two, three. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
All right, we're together now. Thank you all are here today, especially on this special Sunday as we celebrate our graduates and think about good luck for the future. How we can move on. We have other announcements. Please check your insert that has a number of announcements of what's coming up this week. The Bible study and Wednesday's choir practice. Come sing for fun. Come sing for fun. And also next Sunday, we will be celebrating Father's Day. Are there other announcements that need to be added to those?
We miss you a lot.
I am glad to be back. I was asked how it went these last couple of weeks, and I said we're exhausted and happy. Isn't that the way vacation normally is? So, come back, got a chance to see all the branches of Mary Ann's family as we did the big loop through the country. So that was really quite special. Well, we will begin our service today with our call to worship. This is the day. Praise the Spirit of God descend upon my heart. Number 265.
Thank you.
and Emily Harper, grandson of Gene and Pat Stille. He graduated from Arapahoe Charter School High School. Looking forward to attending Pamlico Community College, where he will pursue an electrical degree and a welding certificate. I have an image of that. When I was in Louisville, we would go to Southern Indiana, and right over the bridge and to the right was a huge company that would create barges. And every single morning they would be out and you'd see the sparks flying and everybody doing the kind of welding to keep those things together. But I also know there are distinct areas of welding that one can be certified in. So congratulations. And so in a couple of years, if you have any electrical issues, we know where to go, okay? We got somebody right here. Our second graduate is Kaley Tiarina, who is the granddaughter of Renee Midget and the great-granddaughter of Roger and Polly
Serpidoff.
Okay. She is an Appalachian State graduate with a BS in chemistry. We're lucky to have her stay in the area for a career with Nutrien. I did say Nutrien correctly, did I? Okay. Now for a special.
Casey, we have watched you grow into the young man you are today. From being an animal to a shepherd to a king in our children's Christmas plays to serving as an acolyte, deacon, and as a worship leader. We hope that Bethany Christian Church will be a part of the next chapter in your life, this new journey on which you are about to embark. Congratulations, and may God bless you. Would you come up, please?
Yep, you should have. This way.
I'm going to give this a try. These little pins are not what they're meant to be.
You can hold it.
If I can't do it right, start with them. I'm just going to give it to you. Okay? Because I'm not going to poke you. I'm not going to poke me. It's spinning already. See, it's turned sideways. But that's okay.
That's good.
You good?
Thank you, Casey.
What are you feeling? You've done that. I know the next listing in our bulletin is prayer concerns, but this Sunday is also a time of prayer rejoicing, which we can now do as we graduate. And so instead of starting off with our typical prayer concerns, I would like to ask, are there things that have happened in people's lives that they feel the great joy in? And can I go ahead and assume all this group right here feels the great joy in their graduation? So that's certainly part of our joy prayer. Other times that we have felt the presence of the Lord, oh my heavens. You're graduating, and you're just getting started. your bulletin. Please take those home during the week. Remember those names as you go to your prayer time. Yes?
I just wanted to say thank you for the prayers, and I'm feeling much better. Usually I would have been sick, but this time I was pretty sick. And so I thank you for all the prayers that have been taken on this time.
As you look at the names that are listed on the back of the insert, are there any we should add that are prayer concerns? Service. We pray that your healing
modern music and Christian music is a very strong. We want to bring you not one but two spirits sort of woven together.
Thanks be to God.
A number of weeks ago, we started talking about the great commandment of the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength, and your neighbor as yourself. And we already spoke about the love of God with all of our heart, the ability to be open and to open ourselves to loving devotional practices. And the love of God with all our minds, to continue to study the Word, share our thoughts. The love of God with all our strength is today. However, our Are you will you be taking them out, or I have something for you either way?
You got something?
I got
them. Okay, go for it.
Next Sunday, 11 o'clock. Oh, his house is in Columbia. So if we love somebody else, we give them a heart. And I have a funny feeling, what happens to the faces of your parents when you look at them and you say, I love you? Do they say the same? You know, kind of like, does something happen with their mouths when you say it? Do they smile, you think, when you say that? Yep. Oh my God, you got boo-boos. Old boo-boos. Okay, so we're going to smile that they're old boo-boos. Okay. So how about loving God with all of our mind? That's a little tougher. If you really love something, what's like a hobby or something that you might really like doing? Is there something you really like to do?
Ride dirt bikes.
Ride dirt bikes?
I like to ride scooters.
And you like to ride scooters, okay. Yeah. And once you hop on, oh, you got something?
Play baseball.
Play baseball? Oh, what do you say, lady? What do you like? Is there something you like to do?
Softball.
Softball, too? Okay. Now let me ask you, especially for those who like to play ball.
I like to play soccer ball.
Soccer ball, same thing. Can you go out and just play, throw the ball around, hit it when you want to, or are there rules that you need to learn to know how to play it?
I am not a
baseball. Yeah, good. You know how to play soccer?
I know how to
play baseball. There you go. And were there rules that you had to go by, ways to do it, that you have to learn? Okay, so if you really like something, you got to learn new stuff. Dirt bikes. I imagine you kind of need to know that when you're going through some rough territory, the best idea is to not try to go over a tree stump, but go around it. Is that right?
Okay.
Very good. Today we're going to talk about love the Lord your God with all your strength. I'm going to find out. Are you ready? I need you to be the picture of strength. Like this. Picture of strength. All right. There you go. If you love somebody with all your strength, that's a tough one too. Let's say somebody that's a really good friend of yours at school drops their book bag. How could you show your friend that you care about them with your strength? You can help them pick it up. Or maybe at home. We already said going to your parents and saying, I love you, brings a great smile. I thought I know another thing. Worry, I'll clean up the room by myself. Look at all the smiles I got. That would be loving with all your strength. Can you give me another one of these? Loving with all your strength. Flex that muscle. There you go. So it sounds like you guys already know what we're going to be talking about today. I'll use a lot more words, but you've already got it. Can we pray together? Any of you, would you like to pray? I mean, I'll tell you what to say that you just said. No? Yeah, maybe some other time. Maybe. Okay. I got you in the book. Okay, we'll see. Lord, we give you thanks and praise that sometimes. adults make so complicated and so difficult come simply through the hearts of children. So Lord, help us to continue to be your children, to continue to love you in all the ways and with all the gifts you've been given. We ask this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, guys. All right. Here we go. One more.
All right.
You graced us with that love. The love of heart, the love of study. God gave us minds to use. We're not supposed to put those away. We're supposed to use those as well in our love of God. But now our strength. We have a lot of models for human strength out there today. Just check the list of movies. Well, you had to grieve the last of Iron Man, but still, you can see the old movies. Thor and Aquaman apparently are the big movies that are coming out and will be coming out soon. Black Panther has been with us. Even Superman had a brief time with us, and Supergirl is on TV. And finally, Wonder Woman. But who can ever forget Saturday mornings? 8 o'clock, in brilliant black and white. Here I come to save the day. That means that Mighty Mouse is on the way. Wherever there is a wrong to right, Mighty Mouse will join the fight. On the sea or on the land, he gets the situation well in hand. I saw some of you nodding. Okay. Obviously, there are some things. I see these are in the lobby. Isn't it funny how some things stick with you over the years and years and years? But we also have a number of sports heroes as well. People that we look up to because in their strength, in the exercise of their sport, we admire them. And certainly those who have been in the armed forces. That have seen battle and continue to see battle, the strength and the courage that it takes to do those things. I imagine you all have your favorites. Feel free to just shout them out anytime. Anybody? I've covered all of them. Okay, just about. I mean, let's face it, even the Worldwide Federation of Professional Wrestlers as good guys and bad guys, big, strong men and women, some of them not bad too long, especially if the ratings start going down, then they become good guys, or vice versa. There's this thing about strength, being able to lift things and push things and beat things. I mean, even when I was a kid, there was that phrase, my father can beat your father. I never used it, by the way. Somehow it was part of my childhood. It was out there, what kids would say. One thing that was curious as I was coming through about this idea of strength is a movie came out, Jesus Christ Superstar. And yes, there were a lot of debates as to whether a musical and all that, but the one debate I remember the most was that the actor who was chosen to play Jesus was not considered buff enough. That was the debate. That somehow this scrawny little guy should not be allowed to play Jesus. Jesus had to be taller than all the rest of the disciples and had to be ripped. This was the image that many people wanted Jesus to have. In other words, kind of like a professional wrestler. That's what they wanted Jesus to be. Well, there are all kinds of strength. All kinds of strength that are mentioned in the Bible. Because the word strength itself can also be translated as abilities. Abilities. For example, some of us have been gifted with financial strength, financial abilities. We've already seen that some have the strength of music, and they can bring that strength to play in worshiping the Lord. Some have the strength of teaching and guiding people in Bible studies. Some in serving, they just naturally are pulled towards the need to serve when they hear someone's in trouble or some group has a new idea. They just want to be there. They are called to be there. And some of us have the strength of getting things organized. I can walk into a room and organize things, and Mary Ann will tell me it's not pretty enough. It needs to be organized differently. It needs to be some other way. Our reading today also talks about aspects of strength. The Lord is our strength, but listen to the images that are used. A rock, a fortress, deliverer, shield, horn of salvation, and stronghold. Curiously, most of these descriptions don't even seem to follow the conquering hero image. There's another type of strength that is imaged here. The strength of perseverance. The strength of patient endurance. The rock upon which the storm rages, yet does not yield. The fortress and stronghold, assaulted on all sides, yet still stands firm. The shield upon which the enemy's weapons shatter. The importance of this biblical strength is again stated by Paul in Romans. Therefore, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom also we have obtained our introduction by faith into his grace in which we stand, and we exalt in hope of the glory of God. Not only this, but we also exalt in our tribulations, knowing that tribulation brings about perseverance, and perseverance, proven character, and proven character, hope. And hope does not disappoint. Because the love of God has been poured out within our hearts through the Holy Spirit who was given to us. Exalt in our tribulations. That doesn't sound like a superhero, does it? Superhero gets a tribulation and smashes it like a big Hulk, jumps on top of it. But tribulation, according to Paul, brings about perseverance, patient endurance, as a valuable spiritual strength. Perseverance brings about proven character. I love that phrase, proven character. We can dress like we have a whole lot of character. Think of all those outfits our superheroes wear. But perseverance brings about proven character, what's inside. Not winning the battle by force, yet somehow still winning the battle. And proven character brings about hope. I have to say, I think we do a pretty poor job in our world today teaching perseverance. The idea of the long game versus what I can get within the next 48 hours. I mean, I really believe it started right. Because I think I've heard any number of times the reason why we are working this hard is because we want to make the life of our children easier, which is a noble goal for parents. But somehow along the way, we've gotten to the point where we believe that things need to be fast, easy, and cheap. Now, time for a little confession. I'm not talking about anybody but myself. But let me check here. How many of you really enjoy standing in a grocery store line and you are behind six people, all in the nine items are left, with full grocery carts, and you look down the list and there are only two lines open and 10 available cashier areas, that you might have a bit of a moment of frustration? That would be me. That wouldn't be my my wife. If she was in that line, by the time she came out, she would either already have the name and phone number of somebody who's going to be our new best friend, or at least a name and somebody we need to pray for. But me, I'm counting heads. I'm counting items in the basket. That's what I am. Or how many times have you been in the line in a fast food restaurant? And you want to say to yourself, hey, fast food, where is it? I don't care if it's not automatically made right now. I don't care if you heat it up in a heat lamp, you know, but where's the fast part of food in your establishment? Or, and this is the one that I am truly sinful, truly sinful. When I get really angry at my computer printer because it's not printing fast enough. I'm old enough to remember that when you type stuff up, if you messed up in the last three lines of that page and you had to do it, you had to put a whole new piece of paper in and start typing all over again. And here I am, worried about the speed of my computer printer because I want it now. I mean, through invention and creativity, we've done many things that have made our lives easier. I mean, I'm not questioning a quick and accurate diagnosis that's minimally invasive and at no cost. I'm not questioning the availability of fresh water, electricity, essential foods, and access to education. Yet I wonder about the image of a fast, easy, cheap proclamation of faith. Indeed, we're doing it right now. We are doing it right now as we worship. No one is here to attack our beliefs. No one is here to question our rituals or call out our moments of hypocrisy. And we're going to do it all within a structured 60-minute time period, and you did not even have to pay an admission fee. Now, in all honesty, I'm not talking about you guys at home. If I was at home trying to get my computer up, get on Zoom, make sure I'm there in time for the worship to get started, I know aggravation, okay? So I'm not talking about you. It probably was not fast, easy, or cheap, okay? You know, I believe our daily lives are filled with calls for the kind of perseverance brought about by challenges to our professed faith. Maybe it's time to bring back and in a more serious way, not just for jewelry, in a more serious way, a what would Jesus do mentality. To speak truth to power. To demand accountability from our leaders and expect to be held accountable. To be a voice for those who have no voice, just as Jesus did. To be more willing to suffer and persevere for the love of God and for the marginalized people Christ himself went to. In an effort to more faithfully follow the Lord, we easily worship here right now. If we go to the gym and never lift a weight, how are we going to gain any strength? If we don't do things to strengthen our bodies, curiously enough, if we don't do things to strengthen our bodies, we actually become weaker. It's the same true of our faith. If we don't do things to strengthen our faith, will it weaken from a lack of exercise? If we do not exercise the strengths we've been given in acts of love for the Lord, do we not risk losing those strengths? I guess the phrase, use it or lose it, can be a faith statement as well. And what happens when we need that strength of faith later, when we are beset by challenges and doubts? Will we have weakly sacrificed even our ability to hope? There's a quote I'm sure most of you have heard. It seems to fit here. It's not how many times you've been knocked down that matter. It's how many times you get back up. Yet if we never get into the ring, how can can we fight the good fight? We too easily forget who is in our corner with a bucket of living water and words of encouragement and love. Do we share only the times we fought and won with those that we love, our families and our friends? Or do we also share those times when we may have lost yet gained character in the struggle? I'd say modern news today, before Russia invaded the Ukraine, about the only thing I knew about the Ukrainians were those wonderful Eastern Orthodox eggs. But now that Russia has invaded the Ukraine, and we know that the Ukrainians will not be able to fully beat back that army, the fact that they continue to struggle, haven't we all started to gain a certain amount of respect? And we see the kind of character that is coming out in the midst of this attack. Graduates, made it through all those years to graduate. And now your challenges are going to be out there. They're going to call forth everything that you've learned and probably some things you didn't even know you learned, but suddenly it's there. Your challenges will be great. And especially as a person of faith, your challenges will be even stronger. But at the same time, I would also assure you that even though your challenges to faith may be stronger, that's the very time the Lord is the closest, and so we'll always be there for you. As a church, both here and the larger church, we proclaim a Lord who is willing to suffer and die a human death so that we might have eternal life. Can you imagine his frustration and the perseverance? How many times during those years disciples walk with him, then they come up and start arguing over who can be the best? Or Peter, who looks right at Jesus and says, "You just laid out what your life is going to be." No, 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 no. Can you imagine how many times in his humanness he was so frustrated with these guys who just didn't seem to be able to get it? And he knew what the end of his human life was going to be, and yet say, "I'm done with you 12, I'll get 12 more. I'm going to work with you. I will persevere. I will be the image." Having been given eternal life by his sacrifice, we are challenged. How are we going to demonstrate the strength of the abilities that we have been given by God during our small set? Imagine, eternal life. There is no end to these fingers pointing in both ways. And here's our earthly life in the midst of that eternity. How are we going to spend this time knowing that we had been promised this time? Our strengths are as varied as the people gathered here today, and each of us has at least one God-given strength that's needed by this church and by the church universal. And we all bring our strengths to the table to be offered to the service of the Lord as a demonstration of our love of the Lord. My last comment, I think it's interesting and quite instructive that when Paul in 1 Corinthians goes to define love, the very first word he uses, and it may be in your mind already, the first defining word of love is love. Love is the long game. Amen.
Amen.
During the singing of our hymn of invitation, if you feel called to become a member of this body of Christ here at Bethany Christian Church, I'd invite you to come down forward during the singing of this hymn, "O Jesus, I Have Promised," number 612, verses 1. given us many gifts. You've given us gifts of our own talents, but you've also given us gifts of friends and family, of those who have come into our lives to support us in our travels. Lord, we give you thanks for having offered those gifts to us. And at this time, we begin to consider what offerings we might return to you. Lord, we pray that the offerings that are given, whether they be in talents for this church or whether they be monetary gifts, that all will be used to glorify your name and fulfill the mission that you have given us to spread the gospel throughout this world. And we ask this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We now come to our time of communion and invite all those who profess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior to please join us during this sacred feast. Our hymn of communion, an upper room with evening lamps aside, number 428, verses 1 and 2.
Grace, but most importantly, that love through patience.
They loved him, but they didn't know how. They loved him, but even one was going to betray him to death. And yet still in the strength of the faith that he had. The other image I have is while he is at the upper room and those folks are around and there's all the sounds, even in the midst of that, there was not a smile that crossed the face of Christ. For even on that night that he was to be betrayed, he took bread and he broke it and he said, "This is my body broken for you. Take it. After giving thanks and praise, he said, "This is my blood, the blood of the new covenant poured forth for you. As often as you eat this bread and drink of this cup, do so in remembrance of our Lord and everybody's hands go, "We are strong in the faith."
We are strong in the faith.